Okay, suppose that I have a binomial distribution with n, let's say, equal 10, and p, probability of success, equals, let's say, 30%. So you want to compute some probabilities. I want to show you how to enter this into your Casio calculator. First thing is you want to use the summation that you see here, the summation notation. So shift and then press this. You get this sum from x equal the lower value to the upper value, but leave these until the end. Now, open parentheses within the parentheses, then multiply, open another parentheses, multiply, open another parentheses. You have three things here. And then on this one, you want to raise it to the power n, which is 10, minus x. And to get x, you see that x is here. So you do alpha and x. Now we go to the second one and also raise it to the power, and then it's only x. So you do alpha x, you get it. And then here you need to put nc x. So notice that here I have ncr. So what I will do is shift, before the shift, put the n, so 10. In this case, it's 10. Of course, in other questions, n could be anything, yeah? Shift C, choose, and then you put the X. So alpha, then here. So this is n, choose X, and here you put P, the probability of success. We said that it's 30%, so you go put 30% here, 0.30, and then go to the last parentheses and put 1 minus P. So 1 minus 0.30. Now your formula is complete. All what you need to do is now go back and put the limits of x. X goes from where to where? Okay, so for example, if we want the probability that x equal 5, exactly 5, so you put 5 and on top also you put 5. This is the probability that x is exactly one value, and you hit equal sign. So you get the probability about 10%. Now, let's say that you want to use a different value for x. So you will go back to the same formula. Don't change anything. Once you put the n here, notice that n you put it here and also on top of the last parentheses, the 1 minus p to the power n minus x. So n here is 10. So the 10 appears here and at the beginning when you do 10cx. Okay, so now let's go to change this. Let's say that the question was, so delete this one and delete this one. Okay, so we delete this one also. And now let's go to say x is at least 2. At least 2 means 2 or more. So you put from 2 up to the maximum that x can get is n, so 10. When they tell you at least 2, it means 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 up to 10, the n value. Okay, so you hit equal. This is telling you that the probability is 85%. And I will do one more. So let's say that the question was, let's delete the 10 and also delete the 2, and say that the question was, find the probability that x is at most 4. So if it's at most 4, always you know x starts from 0 and you want to have at most 4, so you stop at 4. So and then hit equal, and that gives you the probability, which in this case is about 85%. Okay? And this is basically what it is. Just remember, for if you have just one value for x that you want to measure, not x from some value to another value, if it was just probability that x equal a specific value, then all what you have to do is to put the value in 2 times. Here you put, let's say, probability x equal 4, so you'll put from 4 to 4, okay, and then you'll get about 20%. So on. Otherwise, just read the question and it will tell you where to put x from where to where. All what I'm trying to tell you here is that leave x from where to where till the end. First, write all of the formula here. So the 10 is n. It could be 15, 20, depending on the question. It could be any number here for n. And then this x is always there. This is p, the 30%. Maybe in another question, p is 60% or 42%. So all depends on what it is. And you raise it to the power x, then 1 minus p to the power n minus x. Okay, I hope that this video helped you.